back to Metal Rules TV, where the underground meets the playground. Jeffrey?
Yes. Remember last week we were talking about post-hardcore?
Yes.
We were learning about what post-hardcore... Are you guys familiar with post-hardcore?
We have played many a show with many of those bands, unfortunately.
How would you describe post-hardcore?
I'm not a fan.
But what is it, though?
It doesn't necessarily have a...
It's not... Okay, if you like the type of music, that's your right to, whatever. Like, it's personally not my style, but that, it's supposedly as you can imagine by the title, is supposed to be a derivative of hardcore punk. If you look at any post-hardcore band, they don't really fit that image. It's all the bands with, the breakdowns and, now they're doing
the
this, now they're doing this choreography. Not even that anymore. The bands with the makeup aren't really even doing that kind of stuff anymore. They've gone like Black Veil Brides, as I won't get into. Now they're doing, the show that I was telling you about, the All-Stars Tour, when we had the captive audience, the first band that we saw play, the first one on the tour package, they came out, first thing we heard was a breakdown, and all four of the people in front, obviously with the exception of the drummer, because he's sitting down, they're jumping to the beat of the breakdown.
Oh my god.
They spin
yeah.
in a circle while still jumping, and then they do this thing with their guitars where they go like that, while they're jumping, and it's this whole choreography thing where they keep going around.
So post-hardcore is
it's getting there now.
Choreographed hardcore dancing.
You heard it here first.
I don't understand. And yes, and you said hardcore dancing, and also a key, if you're not...
If you're not sure
if you're at a hardcore show, and I don't mean to deliver this like Jeff Foxworthy, but anyone who's doing the windmill.
Oh my god.
Is this
going
to
happen?
Oh god.
This is our post-hardcore game. Is it something like this? Is this what you saw? And then we went like this, went for the car?
The spinning motion is there, but you have to do this thing with your arms, where you
try to punch. Alright, picture this.
Oh, no.
Fighting invisible ninjas. That's pretty much what it is.
Yeah.
Oh, ninjas.
You got it. That's the sad part.
Yeah.
Wait, they have to be Asian?
No.
Oh!
You're a ninja in the head!
Oh my god.
That was racist. I apologize.
Yeah, but no, I know you guys have seen it. The windmill and the kicking and stuff like that. And it's,
I tend to associate post hardcore with more spacey-ish kind
of
stuff.
Yeah, I was actually going to say that. It took all the elements of hardcore, the big breakdown things being the central idea, but a lot
and
of
more
these,
pretentious.
honestly, yes, because they use a lot of delay and modulation, a lot of lead guitar parts, and I call them leads, marks, but they have that kind of, you're right, the spacey kind of vibe where it's almost it's a little bit of texturing. So it's almost borrowing from post-rock with stuff God is an Astronaut.
Yeah, exactly,
like, really, out there in the...
And some of it is interesting, but...
Should
we get to the actual story?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought that was the question.
No. The actual story is the post-hardcore band I See Stars.
Just play with them.
Yep.
You know who they are?
Just play with them.
Yeah. You can anyway.
Opened up for them at the All-Star. Played that again this year.
Really?
Yeah. Yes.
Do you realize they were just arrested? The entire band and their crew was just arrested.
I'm not surprised.
On charges of possession and intent to use hallucinogenic drugs.
I'm not, that doesn't surprise
the space
me at all.
The band name is I See Stars.
So did you get to meet these guys and talk to them?
Share hallucinogenics with them?
They look like they're your age or younger.
They're a little older than us, but
really?
I can speak for everyone in our band and who says that we're not big fans of them. But, because we really didn't have any desire to go meet them. But, yeah, I don't know. It's just not, I guess, our cup of tea. It's a shame they got locked up. Charged or what?
They were arrested in Salina, Kansas.
Salina,
I feel like I did hear this.
They were all released after posting $1,000 bond each. Vocalist Devin Oliver tweeted about the incident. Just had the worst 13 hours of my life. Then he tweeted again. First and last time in jail.
I'm going to go ahead and say that last thing may not be true.
That's
definitely what their manager wanted to say that. Yeah.
But they'll be back in jail soon.
Yeah. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying,
we're going to trust in Jesus and do this ever again.
They look like emo dudes.
Yeah.
They have an emo name.
That's another thing that the post-hardcore scene seems to be adopting. Not the emo thing, but, when that when the swoop hair started being a big thing.
Swoop hair.
Bring the swoop
back.
Yeah,
when that became a big thing in, like, the early 2000s, it was all, like, you know, all the kids looked very gothic, you know, like really pale faces.
It's like
dark,
down gothic.
Dark.
Like Casper.
Dark.
Casper. Casper.
Dark, dark eye makeup. They're all dyeing their hair
Casper
black.
Casper the Friendly Ghost.
Skrillex's old band.
Yeah, Skrillex was in a post-hardcore band, and that's exactly what he looked like. You know, you had the, like, if you've ever seen Russell Brand, where he's got, like, the hair in the back, that's all poofed up, it was the swoop with the stuff poofed up in the back.
Like a peacock
and,
look, sort of.
Yeah, and like that was, but now, they're still doing that whole hairstyle and the same type of clothes, but now it's all bright colors.
Yeah, yeah. Even the merch, too, is all like yellow and bright blue. It's like really neon and
like if you look at the guys in I See Stars, their haircuts and they're wearing the tight pants and all the stuff like that, and it's all the same stuff, but it's like it's almost like, you know, you were watching it in black and white before, you know, how color TV was just invented, and now you're like, oh wow, you know. But that seemed, they seem to be...
I just like how the entire band was arrested.
Yeah, that's funny that one person got away.
There's a picture of them, and they're just like, all their, like, you gotta see the picture, like, all the mugshots lined up. And
I hope that it was an actual, like, collective mugshot. Like,
no, they don't do that.
That'd be so funny, just like, we arrested IC Stars.
No, they're all single, but they're all next to each other. There's, like, six dudes in the band.
Yeah, I think so. Now, if they were smart, they'd use them as the promo picks on the next record.
Yeah.
That's what I would do.
That's
what I
would do. Any publicity is good publicity.
Held down by the man.
And it may not be our cup of tea, but you can't argue with results, especially they're on Sumerian Records right now, which right now everything that label is touching is turning to gold.
Yeah.
You know,
Faceless are on.
Yeah, Faceless Periphery.
Oh, awesome.
You know, the Periphery, I was, you know, mentioned them earlier. They, at least in my
promotion right.
In my time, they are the fastest growing band ever. They put out one album and an EP, and all of it, you know, within, you know, a year of each other, and they're headlining worldwide tours and all that stuff. Like, the album that they just put out reached, like, you know, it was, like, on the top 40 Billboard charts.
Well, hopefully you guys will get an opening slot with IC Stars.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, yeah,
again,
we'll take it if we get it. Like, they're the greatest successful band.
Share your hallucinogenics.
Yeah.
Learning from success is intelligent, so.
Teach me to see stars.
Riders on the storm.
On the stars, get it.
That's what we have on post-hardcore and tripping. Yeah.
Trippin' balls.
Bye.